Hi guys, it's Uki again. Today we are taking a look at a Kobi set. It's from the Historical Collection of World War II. It has the set number 2283 and it's called Sonderkraftfahrzeug 251/9, nicknamed Stummel. It consists of 485 pieces and one minifigure. I paid €38 for this set in the spring of 2023. A short historical look at the vehicle. It is an armored personnel carrier and was in service from 1943 to 1945. The German armored personnel carriers had different variations, and this one was armed with a short 7.5 centimeter cannon, the KVK-37L24, but you can also say it was the same cannon as the Panzer IV had in 1940. So it was an infantry supporting cannon, and I personally think, even though I have no data on this, that it was probably that the rearmament of the Panzer IV had the effect that there were cannons that were not used anymore in the tanks, and so they were mounted on these armored personnel carriers. So these armored personnel carriers had, as the name suggests, the task to field infantry onto the battle. So it was kind of a battlefield taxi, and the infantrymen, they were supposed to fight along the tanks, but it was usually the case that the infantry would dismount for the fighting, because these vehicles, even though lightly armored, were very vulnerable to anti-tank and armor penetration capabilities. So it was a very successful design, and the German military used the additional punch these vehicles could carry for all kinds of purposes. The guns, like I said, for infantry supporting, but there were also variations with anti-aircraft guns or with artillery pieces. So anyway, it was always useful to have a little bit more punch on the battlefield. The set itself is built in a 1 to 35 scale, and to be honest, this is why we are taking a closer look at this set, because I try to determine if this vehicle in this scale from Kobi, which is way more attractive from a price point than the Brickmania sets, if we can use them on displays along with the Lego minifigures. So anyway, this set is pretty sturdy for a very detailed small construction toy, but the durability comes only in the very last stages of the build. So you really have to take care where to apply pressure when building this set, when you apply the pieces and the parts that you build with the manual. So when we have a short look at the manual, we have not only building steps, but we have also additional info to the building steps. And when you are just looking at a building step at a time, you probably miss that there are additional things that you have to look after. And of course, there are different kinds of slopes that have they're a little bigger, have a little different of an angle, so you can very much make mistakes by placing them at the wrong place, and this will cause problems. And also how to apply these wheels. They are very easy to be placed mistakenly, and when you remove them, the pins here, they get very easily broken. So there it is really wise to have a good look before you place something. I made some mistakes myself, and it's just unnecessary, and it, of like I said, carries the risk that these pins here, that they just break, and it was ultimately destroy the set from being complete, because there are no spare parts of these. So anyway, this is was what Kobi gave us. There are very detailed reviews out there, so I do not want to make this section too long. I think it was a good build. It was a nice build. I think there are many details considering the scale, and the price point is just very attractive. One thing I would like to point out in terms of quality: we have here a nice camo scheme, but when you have a look at the print here and the brick color, it is just different, and I probably would have suggested to Kobi that if they can't print it in the proper color, then they probably should have gone for a different way for camo. So I would be very much okay if this was a all brown part, and so we did not have these prints, even though I have to admit that this works better than this. I don't know if you see the difference in the on the screen, but in this case, when they have printed this brown here with the number 543, it is a little bit distracting and probably unnecessary. So anyway, I will switch to the display section of this video, and afterwards I will close out with some music and with some detailed pictures. Maybe one last word for the minifigure. I know most people I know don't really care about the Kobi minifigures, but I think they are a good improvement from their minifigures from a few years ago. So now we have a decent try to not only get good prints, but also to have a look of the soldiers as human beings and not as some sort of gremlins. So that's an improvement after all. So anyway, I will see you soon. So I'm back with the display section of this video. I used some custom Lego minifigures from United Bricks for this little display. They are late war German infantrymen, and in this scene they have just dismounted from the Sonderkraftfahrzeug and are on the way to support their tanks. I think the scale overall is okay. I mean, Lego minifigures don't have a real human scale, so you just can't get it completely right, but I think it is okay and way better than the 1-28 from Kobe, and considering the price for 83 euros that I paid, I'm very pleased with the look. Of course, I would really like to compare this with a model from Brickmania, but as time of filming I don't have one, but if I get the chance to lay my hand on one, then I will certainly try to make this comparison. So let's have a look at the fighting compartment. The cannon is a little big, but it works after all. You have to carefully place the minifigure that it stands, but I think it works. So anyway, what do you think? Do you think that this is an option to use Kobe models with Lego minifigures? If you like to, please write your opinion in the comment down below. And I thank you very, very much for watching. I hope you found this video a little interesting. I hope you have a great day, and I will see you next time. Bye bye.